My grandfather's clock was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny, weighed more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and pride. But it stopped short, never to go again. Life seeking slumbering, it stopped short, never to go again. When the old man died, my grandfather said that of those he could hire, not a servant so faithfully found. For it wasted no time and had but one desire, ere the close of each week, and it kept in its place, not a frown upon its face, and its head never hung by its side. But it stopped short, never to go again. When the old man died, it rang in the alarm in the dead of the night, an alarm that for years had been dumb. Knew that his spirit was blooming for flight, that his hour for departure had come. So the clock kept the time with a soft and muffled chime, as we silently stood by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again. His life seeking slumbering, it stopped short, never to go again.